Hello, good evening, everyone. First of all, I want to introduce MTT. MTT is a marketplace for private tutors, schools, and academicians. Our mission is to make quality education affordable to all and easily available. Right now, we are also working on a recruitment process. I welcome you all on today's IELTS Masterclasses. Our speaker is Anita Ma'am. She is a competent professional with 20 years of experience in counseling, training, and development and teaching operations, proficient in imparting training for learning Chinese and Italian language to corporates, individuals, and exporters, experienced in providing consultancy to the students for overseas education in USA, UK, and Canada. The merit of being trained in Thai, Italian, and Mandarin Chinese language and worked as an interpreter for the Italian language, imparted training to various corporates like Perfetti Indian LTD, FIAT Premier, JP Morgan, and etc. It's very nice to know you, ma'am. It's a very good profile of yours. Over to you.
Okay, thank you so much for introducing me. First of all, good evening, everybody. And I thank the organizer, MTT, for giving me a chance to speak to the audience. And I thank all of you people, those who have joined today's session, finding out your time on a Saturday evening. Before I start, I would request all of you to have a pen and paper in your hand so that if you find any points notable and worthy, you can always jot down the points. Second thing, I would request all of you to be present till the end of the session so that you can have some takeaway from the sessions. So let us begin with. Before I start, I would like to share my screen as well. Yeah. So welcome to today's session of IELTS Masterclass. This is Anita Purohit. As Radhika introduced me, I would also like to say something about myself. I'm a linguist by profession. I teach people Mandarin, Chinese, Thai, and Italian. I have been doing all this training since year 1997 or 2000 onwards. Also, I am a study abroad consultant based in the city of Mumbai. We have been coaching students for different competitive exams like GRE, GMAT, SAT, TOEFL, IELTS and all. And we have placed successfully a lot of students in places like USA, UK, Canada for higher studies, masters and MBA and all. Now, this is a session specifically for IELTS, so let us focus on IELTS. I would like to a little bit talk to all of you about my journey or our journey so far in the field of counseling and coaching and training. Now, my next, here is a slide before all of you, which talks about, and also I head an organization in the name of Purohit Academy based in the city of Mumbai, Andheri. So we conduct seminars in various engineering colleges. And this is a picture of, in the slide you on the right hand side, you can see it's a seminar going on about higher studies in USA in the famous prominent Bourbon's College in Andheri. And on the left hand side of the slide, all of you can see it is there are various applauds we have got because of our continuous and value added services to people. This was Times of India. It has applauded us years back, giving us a write off in the newspaper. So this is portion of the write up which we got in Times of India. Moving on to my next slide. Besides being a trainer, counselor, and a linguist, I also write books. So this was my first book, which was published in September 2019. The title of the book is Multilingual, Your Way to Success, with the subtitle, Fall in Love with Your Passion. So the point of something came to my mind that just by teaching people definitely offline, you reach a lot of people. But when you put all your things, your experience of teaching or training people and counseling in a book, you can reach to more number of millions of people all over the globe. This book talks about all about the benefits of learning Mandarin, Chinese, and Thai. So this is adjudged as a best-selling, Amazon best-selling author book in September 2019. This is my first ever published book, and I have 4-5 books in the pipeline. So besides being into training, coaching, and counseling, I also write books. So I try my best to pen down all my experiences down the years, so many years of my being in the field of coaching, counseling, and training. So this book is available in Amazon. You all can always find out. Anybody who would be interested can always dial me so that I can courier a book. Now moving on to my next slide. I already have spoken a little bit about myself, but here this page gives you some infos. So in the field of counseling and coaching and being a bestseller, I have counseled over thousands of people over the years, and also with a rich experience of 25 years in various areas of counseling and guiding students for their career prospects in different countries like USA, UK, Canada, and all. Besides, I am the director of Purohit Academy, which is a very old organization in Andheri, Mumbai. So my main motto of serving people, of catering to people is, I believe in quality over quantity. So when we talk about quality, it's whatever you're doing, you have to give a value-based service, basically. You have to be very much value-oriented so that it helps you, rather than looking for volume. Now moving into IELTS, come to the topic of today, IELTS. The abbreviation to IELTS is International English Learning and Testing Services. Our language testing services. Earlier they used to call it as learning and testing services. Now they have changed the abbreviations to language testing services. Now who are the people who look for IELTS training? And why it is basically needed? Why do one needs to write the IELTS exam? Basically, it opens up various doorways or opportunities for people, those who clear the IELTS exam. So now let us look at the various options and why one should choose IELTS. Why? As in the slide, you can see various pictures. So for studies abroad, somebody who is looking for a higher studies in countries like USA, UK, Canada, Australia, and New Zealand should have a score of IELTS. If you are looking for a job in any of the countries like USA, UK, Canada, then New Zealand and all, even you need to clear the IELTS exam. Then again, people from the hotel industries, they look for jobs abroad, they need to have a score of IELTS. So this exam is a universal, it's a global exam, and it is user-friendly, and the scores are easily accepted by companies as well as institutes and all. So people opt for IELTS over other exams. Now, look at the other, the types of exams in this IELTS. I hope the audience, those who are there, following what I'm saying. If you do not follow anything, make a point so you can put down in the chat box.
Yeah, ma'am, we are following. Yeah, ma'am.
You can always put it in the chat box. Your questions, I would love to answer. Even though we have less number of audience, I would love to respond to your questions and all. Now, the type of IELTS exam, there are two modules of this exam. One is general module and the other one is academic module. General module of IELTS is meant for people, those who are applying for a PR visa or those who are applying for, for immigration and all to countries like New Zealand, Canada, Australia and all. Academic module is meant for people, students, those who are applying for higher studies to USA, UK, Canada, Australia and all. Now, moving on to the next slide, let us see the components, the structure of the exam. IELTS has got four sections. You have listening, you have reading, you have writing, and you have speaking. The listening, reading, and writing, this is the theory portion, and the speaking is the practical sort of thing like on the second day. So the listening, reading, and writing is done on day one, and the speaking is done on day two. Now, let us go deep into the in detail. What are the listening sections all about? What is the reading section all about? What is the writing section all about? And in the audience, people, those who are there present now, any of you know already what is the IELTS exam, or people you do not have any idea about? Do you like to mention in the chat box? If somebody has got some idea about IELTS exam, or you do not have any idea about the IELTS exam. Nobody is responding, so I don't know the kind of...
Ma'am, actually, I don't have any idea about it. So I'm interested to know more.
Because every time when we conduct a webinar, we have two different type of audience. Some people, they already have some idea. Some people, they do not have any idea about the particular exam. So as I explained you what is IELTS, let us go deep into the different sections of this particular test. You have listening as the first section of the IELTS exam. So the listening section basically tests your ability to listen to a task in British accent, because we are a non-native speaker of English language. And when we go to a country, choose a country destination as our study, higher studies, where their mother tongue is English. So it is very difficult for us to understand. If you do not understand what the professor is teaching, spending lakhs of rupees and going to a university for your higher study doesn't make any sense. Many people fail to understand the lecture and they fail drastically in the exam. So basically, this is like an entrance exam. It also, you need a passport to go abroad for higher studies. This IELTS exam is like a second passport, you know, for your higher studies. Unless and until you have a score, you provide the needed score in the exam to the university, you do not get an admission. So this is mandatory. So, and people opt for IELTS exam over parallel exams like PT or you know, it is TOEFL. These are all, again, English entrance exams. So people opt for IELTS because it is user-friendly and you get both the module of this exam. In IELTS, you have pencil and paper-based as well as computer-based. So you have both. Many people, those who are not very much user-friendly in the computer, they opt for pencil and paper, PBT module. So that becomes easy for them to write the essay and submit the paper. And physically, during this corona time, this COVID time, centers are open and many people are opting for, you know, IBT, the computer-based module. So because of social distancing and all, many people are opting for CBT module rather than opting for PBT, wherein you need to go to a center and write the exam. Even in the CBT module, I mean the computer-based module, you need to go to the center, but you do not have to interact with anybody. You have to be just before the system. So let us look at the listening section. It will be for 25 to 30 minutes with a total of 40 to 41 questions. I am just giving you people, those who do not have any idea of the exam, the structure of the IELTS exam. There is a total of 40 to 41 questions. Spread it through four sections. And the type of questions that you are getting in the listening section is the MCQ, which is multiple choice question. You have fill in the blanks. You have sentence completion. Then you have a couple of tables with blanks. We need to fill in the blanks. So this listening, hardly a master can do anything. Suppose you take the coaching, but in the listening, no teacher can do anything. It is you only have to listen very, very carefully and do well, so that one has to listen and develop a habit of understanding and listening to an Australian accent or maybe, you know, a British accent. So this is how it goes. Now I would like to give some quick tips on the listening section. Listen very carefully to a different to an alien accent, and suppose there are 40-41 questions as I mentioned. In the process of listening, suppose we do not follow anything, we don't have to get stuck up, what the speaker said, and you do not go on pondering over there, what the person said. Suppose you get stuck there and you keep on thinking what the person, the speaker said, then you lose the thread and you cannot go ahead with it. Because the speaker does not repeat what he is saying. So we have to listen. They only speak once. So that is one clue I can always share with everybody. In the process of listening, when you are responding to the listening questions, you have to go with the flow of the speaker when you are listening. And when you are doing the listening questions, three things happen. We are looking at the question, we are responding to the question, at the same time we are listening. So our eyes, the eyes are seeing at the question, the hands are writing the responding to the question, at the same time our ear, the ear is listening. So three things we have to synchronize and go together. So these things are very much, it is an act of concentration. How much you are fully concentrated yourself, you concentrate, you can do better. This is how it happens. Now, so that is all about the listening section. Coming to the reading passage, the reading comprehension section tests somebody's ability to analytically understand, read a passage and understand, and it also tests your analytical understanding of how much you understand the English language. So there are 60 minutes they allow to do the reading. Basically, the listening, reading, and writing, that is for 1 hour, 3 hours in one day, day one. And the PI, the speaking is hardly for 15 minutes. So the speaking is very much like a PI, personal interview. So when you are doing a reading sections, test your ability to read standard English script for the IELTS exam and understand and think and respond to a set of questions. So the total time allotted is 60 minutes for the RC, and there is a total of 40 to 41 questions that we need to solve. There are people, those who are writing the academic module of the exam, you have 3 passages to solve. And people, those who are writing the general module, you have to have 5 passages with a total of 40-41 questions. And the type of questions that you are getting is paragraph and statement matching. So when we speak of paragraph and statement matching, there will be some, say, 8 to 9 statements, questions. We need to match from which this particular question has come from which paragraph. And what they do in the IELTS passages, the entire passage length will be for 1 page or 2 page. If it is an academic passage, it will be for 2 pages. If it is a general module, the length of the passage is hardly 1 page. So what they do, they subdivide the passage into, and they rename it as A, B, C, D, like that. So the sub paragraphs, they name it as A, B, C, D, like that. So every statement from which paragraph it has come, we have to match that. Statement 1 has come from paragraph A, statement B has come, statement 2 has come from paragraph C, something like that. Many people find it too difficult. Unless and until you have a clear understanding of the content of the paragraph, you will not be able to match. So even to solve the RC, it needs huge concentration. You have good understanding, should have good understanding of the English language and understand what the author has spoken. So this is filling the blanks question are there, MCQs will be there. Then there is something called yes, no, not given question. Let us learn something about the yes, no, not given questions. So when you are solving the RC, you have yes, no, not given questions. When you say yes, no, not given, there is a statement in the question. We have to understand whether that particular statement, it appears in your paragraph or not. If it appears as it is, then you take it as yes. If it appears in a paragraph, but in a contradictory, in a different manner, then you take it as no. And if the particular statement does not at all appear in your passage, then you take it as not given. So hope you understand what I'm trying to say. Many people find it too difficult to solve this yes, no, not given type of questions. These are called choice type questions. So this is a quick tip that I shared with all of you. Yes, so, and then you have fill in the blanks type questions as well. So when there are fill in the blanks questions, we have to fit in the blanks with a maximum of 2 to 3 words. Using more words would nullify your scoring. So one has to be very, very careful there also. Now looking at that is all about the RC section, the second section. So we spoke about listening section. We spoke in brief about the reading comprehension passages. Then you have a third section of the day one of the exam, which is the essay writing section. In the writing sections, it tests your ability in writing and analytical understanding on a specific topic, presented to you and give your own views on it. Now what happens? In the writing session, they will give you 2 tasks. One is task 1 and the other one is task 2. The task 1 time allotted is 20 minutes. The task 2 time allotted is 40 minutes. So it is a total of 60 minutes, which is 1 hour. So basically what happens in task one, they would give you a diagram, they would give you a pie chart, they would give you some bar graphs with some information depicted or conveyed through those pie chart, bar graph and all. This is for the academic module. So we have to look at the diagram, the pie chart, the bar graph, or maybe any other diagram, and understand the information conveyed through the pie chart or bar graph. And then you have to elaborate that. The words allowed are 150 words, and time allowed is 20 minutes to prepare your task one. So one has to be really, really be careful about preparing that. This is for the academic module. When it comes to general module of the IELTS exam, in the task one, you will have a letter writing or you will have a report writing. So when it comes to letter writing, it could be a formal letter, it could be an official letter also. If it comes to report writing, there is a survey report that you need to prepare. Some survey was done on something and you have to prepare a report. So when it comes to survey, suppose somebody is doing a survey in the city of Mumbai, depending on the age group, the literacy rate among the age groups went so, male and female. So somebody has done a survey and we have to prepare a report of that. So this is called report writing. So mostly in the general module in task one, they would ask you to prepare a letter or prepare a report. This is very difficult because they allow only 20 minutes and there is a word restriction, 150 words. We have to prepare the task one in the 150 words basically. So one has to be very, very careful. Read the topic well, prepare some points in an optional paper, they would allow you rough paper, and then you start writing. This is all about task one. I hope all of you are following this, people, those who are present here. If yes, Now coming to task.
This is the topics are in this questions and listening skills.
Sorry?
On what basis the question are based?
It could be any passage. Yeah, this is a good question. The listening and the RCS, they pick topics. Mostly the questions for the IELTS are prepared by Britishers. It is prepared in UK. So they pick topics based on computer science, based on any scientific invention, agriculture based, any topic. It could be based on anything. Some lecture, something. Say, for example, in one of the IELTS Cambridge book, there was a passage where the topic was, in Hong Kong, in China, in Hong Kong, due to scarcity of space, land surface, they prepared an airport solidifying portion of the sea surface, sea level. So what they did, this is called Cheklap Airport, the name of the airport. It is called Cheklap Airport, basically. So what they had done, I was talking about a topic of essay, the RC. They prepared an airport on the surface of solidifying the sea surface. And that was then later that airport was named as Cheklap. So the point here is listening topics are interesting. And RC topics are also very, very interesting so that the audience, the reader finds it interesting and concentrate fully on reading it. So this is how it is. We discussed about task one and task two also. In the task two, hi viewers, are you all there with me?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay. Talking about the essays, task one and task two. So when you are preparing a task one, we have to be very, very careful about usage of word. We have to have 150 words maximum. By any chance, if you exceed it by 20 words or 10 words, that is perfectly fine. But you just cannot, exceed it by more than 170. So they start giving you negative marks. That is what for task one. And when you are preparing the task one, we have to be very, very specific. And we just cannot exaggerate when you're preparing the task one. Same thing happens when it comes to task two. You have a maximum of 250 words. So you really need to read the topic very well. Task two is basically a topic they will give you. we have to read the topic and elaborate it well, thoughtfully. So task two scoring is a little bit difficult. They look at how well the person has organized the topic, how the grammatical skills and all, whether you are befitting and you have responded to the task according to what the examiner is asking out of you, and the words allowed are 250 words. So if it exceeds by 10-20 words, still it is fine. But if your words exceed beyond 270, they will start negative marking. So this is how it goes. So this is, these are the things that I have, the tips I shared with all of you people. So when you're preparing a task two, one has to be very, very careful. You should practice ideally 20-30 essays, writing essays. Many people, those who come to us for coaching, some people from IT sector, some people those who are working and all, they plan to apply abroad for either for studies or for PR and all. So these kind of people, they have left their studies for years together, and suddenly they start sitting to study, and mostly people are working on computer these days. So they do not have the habit of writing. No. Thank God that they have introduced the CVT module here also in IELTS. So many people find it easy to type the essay rather than writing using a pen, pencil and paper. So before it was pencil and paper exam only. So people really had to struggle a lot to practice writing, because most of the people are working online these days and people have lost the habit of writing using a pen and paper. So the one who is preparing, opting for a PBT module, has to really, really prepare and practice well writing essays. So this is some ideas I have just shared with about writing essays. You still have some tips on how to prepare the body. When we prepare a topic two, the task two, the essay, you have introduction, you have body, and you have paragraph. So basically the task two should have three components, three segments. You have intro, body, and conclusion. So here in this particular page of my slide, it gives you about the organization of your task two. As there is an example topic mentioned here, smoking should be prohibited at schools and colleges. Then again, I would like to share the audience that the task two topic, it could be either based on issues, or it could be based on arguments. So being a trainer for so many years, so I can just talk for hours together about all the IELTS to Z, but this is a short session, so we have to cut short our talk. But there are a lot of things one has to take care when somebody is preparing for the IELTS exam. You have to understand the E2Z of it, how to prepare, what kind of books you should refer. And again, one more thing I would like to share to the listener or the viewers, my audience today, that when you are preparing for the IELTS exam, it is not only the prescribed books you should study for IELTS, but at the same time, you should have a passive habit of, listening to BBC News, reading newspapers and all, read novels to increase your reading speed. So these things matters and this really helps you. So here, this is the topic given here. Smoking should be prohibited at schools and colleges. Reasons to agree and disagree. So here, you have the main body of the paragraph. Then you write the topic sentence. Then you write supporting sentence. Two, either to support your topic or to, if you do not support also. So the IELTS essays, if your topic, the task two topic is based on argument. So the either you support the particular topic or you refute the topic. Like IELTS essays allow you to discuss both the points of view. Either you are supporting it or you are refuting it also. Unlike in GRE and GMAT. Somebody who is preparing for a GRE exam or GMAT exam, they do have essay writing. They do not allow to discuss both the point of view views. If the particular essay is based on argument, you simply have to discuss one point of view. This is not the case when you are writing a task two of IELTS. They allow you, the examiner allows you to discuss both the points of view. Now, these are steps given here, how do you prepare your task two? Grouping the reasons to disagree into one paragraph, grouping the reasons to agree into another paragraph, give your own personal views or opinions and end the topic with viable solutions to the problem. So this is some tips that I am sharing with all of you about the essay section. Now coming to the speaking section, the speaking section tests a person's speaking skills on a particular topic presented instantly to him or her. So it is like an extempo talk. There will be a, if it is a virtual exam, then you have to speak before the computer. If it is physically you are going to the center, then you will have an examiner. So it's very much like a PI, personal interview. And the speaking is hardly for 15 minutes. And there are three parts to the speaking. You have a part one, you have part two, and part three. Let us know more details about what are the contents of part one, part two. So in the part one, they would ask you to introduce yourself. That is hardly for some time. The entire part one is for 5 minutes, part two is for 5 minutes, and the part three also is for 5 minutes. So there is a total of 15 minutes for the speaking sections. In the part one, you need to introduce yourself, and then the examiner asks you a couple of questions, which are just common questions and all. In the part two, the examiner hands you over a cue card, an envelope wherein a particular topic is written. You need to open the envelope, read the topic, think for a while, and present your topic before the examiner. So this is how it is. Even though this is a speaking exam, in the part two, they allow you to jot down your points. If you want to jot down your points, they do allow you to jot down your points. So this is how it is. In the part three, the examiner asks you a couple of short questions, like say 5 to 6, or say sometimes it is more also. If the speaker is good, even the examiner finds interesting and they keep on asking more questions. And they would ask you some one-liner answer questions so that you have to respond to the questions. So this is how it goes. So this is all about the speaking exam. In the speaking exam, I would like to highlight and say something that the examiner not really looks at the grammatical skills or the speaking skills of the individual. But at the same time, they look at the person's presence of mind, because how much ever you prepare, they would ask any topic from the blue. So you really have to be very, very careful, and you have to be smart enough in responding to the topic. So this is all about now let us discuss something more about during this COVID, how one should, this is a different time that we all are passing through. So not all the centers in all over India and all over the globe are functioning. There are a lot of centers for the exam centers are non-functional. So one has to understand which all centers are functioning. So you really have to dial the IDP or visit the website of IDP or British Council Division to understand the exam centers availability, and you can dial them or you can visit the website of idpindia.com or British Council Division to get to know the exam dates. And earlier, there are more exam dates available, but these days also, not so many exam dates available, because not a lot of people are appearing for the exams at this point of time because of this COVID. So I hope things should come down to a normal in a couple of months down the line. So visual information, one can visit the IDP site or British Council site and understand. Even we do assist as trainers or coach, help people in getting registered for the exam. Once somebody is coming for a coaching, we do help people. And I was a nodal agent to IDP for quite some years. So we have some kind of tie-up with IDPs and all. Now moving on to my next slide. As I mentioned in the beginning of my presentation today, that we have the institute in the name of Purohit Academy, which is a pretty old organization based in Andheri, Mumbai. Since 1997, we have been catering to people. Why should one choose the Purohit Academy or us to join for any help in IELTS exam? So let us do that. When we coach people, when you are training people for the IELTS exam, we do maintain a step-by-step approach, one-to-one coaching always, and there are a lot of notes and books provided for the preparation for the exam, study material in the sense, and we do help the person in getting all the doubts cleared tips are given how to solve questions in the RCs and all to get a good score. I personally teach and I have one or two trainers also. And we always maintain a very cordial approach with all the people who should come. So basically the intention is to that whoever is coming for a class or getting some assistance, the idea is that the person should score the maximum possible score. I mean, on a 9 band, this is on a 9 band score, the ITS exam. Everybody till now has scored 7.5 and above. Nobody has scored below that. So 8 and above is considered to be a very good score, band score in ITS exam. So always one should have a target of getting an 8 band, I feel. And so this is all my presentation. So as a trainer and coach, I definitely feel very satisfied and happy helping a lot of people and guided a lot of people. And now at the end of the session, I would like that whoever is there, even though there are few people for the session, I would like that everybody, whoever is willing to take our services now during this lockdown and COVID time, it is provided online. If it is people are based in Mumbai, we send you hard copies of the book. Even people are away from Mumbai, we send you hard copies of the book. PDF format of the books are also available to give you. So we do cater to all the people in the best possible way, whether it is an online learning, offline learning also. So and we appear in all these places like YouTube and Insta and Facebook. So I would request all of you to follow us. So this is the end of my presentation today. I wish I would have had more people, but I thank all of you to be patient and stay till the end of the session. And I